Lost Plantations of Louisiana, Thierry Bricklow, 1917. Derceto was a small plantation on the eastern shore of Lake Pontchartrain. The land was considered difficult for industry and was sold for only $30 to Elijah Pickford in 1818. Pickford employed hundreds of workers from nearby New Orleans to clear the woods and build a small plantation mansion facing the lake with a striking Greek Revival temple facade. Derceto kept a modest production of barrique tobacco and indigo that persisted up till the Civil War. During the antebellum era, Derceto was the source of many rumors concerning voodoo and witchcraft. People who traveled the lake reported seeing people dance at night in front of bonfires, bleating and wailing. On June 17, 1862, Captain J.W. Norton of the Union Army recounts leading a raiding party from ships anchored in Lake Pontchartrain in order to seize control of Derceto and free the slaves working there. The captain was surprised to find the workers fighting back with unprecedented zeal. Norton's account describes these men and women as enraged with fanaticism. Pickford reportedly tried to placate the raiders, but was shot in the confusion. Captain Norton left the mansion burning and retreated to his ships with his men. Derceto was left in ruins for several decades. The ownership of the land was long disputed and returned to the Ledoux family in 1901. Several police reports were filed during the following years as the Ledoux tried to get rid of a camp of squatters on their land. The police made several visits to remove the trespassers, but the people kept returning. On November 1, 1907, Inspector Legrasse of the police charged a deadly attack in order to save several children kidnapped by the squatters. Many were killed, and even more were jailed. The following year, Ledoux rebuilt Derceto, incorporating the surviving stone foundation and adding a magnificent wrought iron conservatory. The farmland had been reclaimed by the surrounding woods, so it was no longer profitable to use as a plantation. Instead, the house was turned into an artist's colony. The Astarte Artist Colony was a successful group of artists, including figures such as painter Heinrich Cassel and poet Nora Keith. The group was also known for their beloved Mardi Gras crew called the Pirates of Pontchartrain. On September 29, 1915, a tropical hurricane tore through Louisiana, causing Lake Pontchartrain to flood New Orleans. Due to the remote location of Derceto, it took almost 2 weeks for outsiders to learn that the artist's colony was abandoned. The 12 residing artists had all vanished without a trace. The empty mansion of Derceto still stands on the shore of Lake Pontchartrain, with much of its temple facade intact. The Ledoux family currently has no intention of repairing the house.
Are you reading anything good?
A Brightness from Afar by Lord Boleskine? It's actually not bad.
It's wet shut. understand what's happening. What are you doing sneaking around? You almost scared me to death.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to disturb your ritual. I wouldn't have guessed voodoo was in practice at a place like this.
The doctor may be all about science, but I know these roots have power.
You know what's going on here? I have a feeling Dorsetto is cursed.
There are several players with stakes in this game. Dorsetto isn't cursed or blessed. It's a battleground. And it would all be a lot better if you could get your uncle out sooner than later.
That's all I'm trying to do.
I wish you the best of luck, Miss Harwood. I really mean that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to look after my gumbo.
The housekeeper buried something in the flower patch beneath one of Dr. Gray's windows. She was singing in some Creole language, performing a peculiar bourgeois voodoo ritual. Certainly not an unfamiliar sight in the French Quarter, but voodoo had never felt this bitter to Emily.
It worked. Now what's this? What's that? There we go. What's that stain? Looks like some kind of rot.
You know, Mr. Waits, I saw a piece of the plate that Liza broke. I think she's been hiding them. She's not very good at it. She just chucked it into the little room with all the tools behind the boiler. I left it there. I didn't want to embarrass her by picking it up while she was looking. We went upstairs instead and played backgammon. I let her win, because she's so unhappy. The piece looked like the one on display in Cassandra's room. You know about that one already, right? Or is your eyesight really that fuzzy? I hope you don't feel bad about your glasses. You only look stupid when you squint. Maybe if you had more eyes, you would see these things. I wish you had all the eyes you needed. Your best and favorite guest, Grace.
It's another one of those plates for the talisman. It's also broken and missing some pieces.
The boiler seemed unremarkable, except for the broken decorative plating on the side. It looked similar to the ritual bench that Emily used in Miss Jackson's place to open the door leading back to DeSetto. Emily wondered why it was broken and if it had been deliberately sabotaged. If so, why? Emily figured she would find out later and focused on finding the broken pieces and mending the plate.
It's wet shut. I think I've seen this somewhere. There was something in the Commonplace book about this. Did it break? The clock just stopped. Showing me something. That's just the hallway outside Jeremy's room, isn't it?
Is here.
Emily deserved a sense of triumph, but she was too on edge to appreciate her success. There was no reasonable explanation why the talisman let her open up this other world. Was this really happening, or was this somehow all in her mind? There was no time to question her own sanity. She had to find Jeremy. If he was here, she thought, would she find Jeremy in the hateful mound?
I did it. I opened up another dream.
Thank you. May 1923, Monday. All okay, ready for delivery. Maintenance, oil pump must be serviced. Any tampering causes large spills unless properly forestalled. Tuesday, shipment delayed but delivered. Maintenance, service bridge close to broken. Wednesday, prospectors reluctantly agreed to show the burial mound to Mr. Hotwood, a painter, who read about our finds in the papers. He means to return tomorrow and try to find a way inside. Thursday, Mr. Hotwood's efforts delayed. The workers seemed nervous about his presence. Hotwood promised not to return to the compound. Instead, he has taken up an offer by L'Officier, the riverboat captain, who means to pilot him to the site tomorrow morning. Hopefully, that's the end. Work can resume. Maintenance. Bridge from the oil tower to the bayou has collapsed. Sabotage suspected.
This is the devil that guides us now.
I need the key. There's something missing.
Here we go.
worked. What's this? I can break this, I just need something to hit it with.
Thank you. Thank you.
There has to be a way to get to the other side. Don't look down, Emily. How is that? Hateful Mount Jeremy mentioned in his book. Jeremy, you dropped your...
Mrs. Marcus?
Get off of me!
What are you doing here?
Trying to find my uncle.
Jeremy is your uncle?
Could you please? Thank you. And it's Miss Hartwood.
You don't remember me?
I remember you, Mr. Bois. I met your brother, Baptiste, earlier.
I suppose he hadn't found Jeremy either then. We spread out to find him.
Can I have this? I'm trying to get to Tarawea.
Fine, but leave the rest. I just want Jeremy to come looking. We have to leave before it comes inside.
What? Where?
Come quick!
Oh, God damn my soul. I'm back at Dorsetto.